In this video, I'm going to solve one rational equation just to kind of give you the process and how you would go about solving any rational equation because they are all done the same way. All right, so in this example, I've got x over 3 plus 3 over x equals 4. The first thing I need to do is I need to look at my denominators and find out if there are any restrictions, all right? Because as you know, we cannot divide by 0. This denominator is a 3, so I don't have to worry about that. This is 9 over x, all right? So if the rule says I cannot divide by 0, then that means x cannot be 0. So I need to note that restriction before I even start working the problem, okay? So my restrictions on this, x cannot be 0. So if I solve this equation and I get x equals 0, I know that can't really be a solution. I've got to throw it out because I have a restriction right there. All right, now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to eliminate those fractions. I don't like working with fractions. All right, it's going to make the problem a whole lot easier if we do not have fractions. So I'm going to multiply through by the least common denominator. So I'm going to look at all my denominators, and I'm going to come up with what the least common denominator is. I have a 3, I have an x, so 3 times x is going to be the least common denominator. Now, technically, I need to multiply all parts of this rational equation by 3x. All right, a lot of teachers or a lot of people will write it next to all three items. I personally think that clutters up the problem. So what I usually do is I put parentheses around the entire expression. I put my least common denominator out here because I'm going to multiply it, and then I just distribute it to each one of the terms on the inside. All right, this cleans it up and keeps it a little bit nicer that way. All right, now, if I have chosen the correct least common denominator and I do this next step right, I should eliminate all of my fractions. So 3x times x over 3, all right, well, these two 3s are going to cross out, so they're going to be gone, and I'm going to be left with x times x, which is an x squared. And then plus, then I'm going to distribute here. When I take 3x times 9 over x, the x's are going to cross out. I'm going to be left with 3 times 9, which is 27. When I distribute here, this is not a fraction. All right, neither is this, so I'm just going to straight multiply this. 3 times 4 is going to be 12, and I'll have the x with it. All right, now, what has happened now is it has created a quadratic equation. So I'm going to solve it, preferably, hopefully, by factoring and solving. If not, I would have to use quadratic formula. But in regardless, to set this up, we need to write this so that all three terms are on the same side. X squared needs to be first, the x term needs to be in the middle, and your plain number needs to be on the end. So when I subtract 12x from both sides, I'm going to have a 12x. Then I'm going to go minus, going to have an x squared minus 12x, because I want that in the middle, so I'm just going to go ahead and put it there. Plus 27 equals 0. Now this is in a form that I can look at and decide if it factors or whether or not I'm going to need quadratic formula. Things that multiply to 27 but add to a negative 12, looks to me like I can use 3 and 9. So this one is going to be one that can factor. So x and x would go here because x times x is going to give me that x squared. Products of 27 are 3 and 9. 3 times 9 is 27, and it needs to be positive. The middle term needs to be negative, which means both of these need to be negative as well. Negative 3x and negative 9x will give me the negative 12x in the middle. All right, at this point, you're going to use the zero property principle here, which says basically I can set this equal to 0 and solve. So x is going to equal 3, or I can set this one equal to 0 and x is going to equal 9, okay? That or that. Now, at this point, you do need to take both of these answers and plug them back in to make sure that you have a true statement. Most of the time, you can do that in your head as long as it's a simple equation. X equals 3. If I plug it in here, it's going to give me 1 plus 9 divided by 3 is 3, so 1 plus 3 does equal 4, so this one checks. If I plug 9 into both of those places, 9 divided by 3 gives me a 3, plus 9 over 9, which would be 1, so 3 plus 1 is going to give me a 4, so this one checks as well. And I'm going to write my solution in a solution set. That would be using set notation. Then I would have a 3 and a 9. And you can clearly see I did not break any of my restrictions here, and this one has two answers. So just one straightforward example of a rational equation, how you would go about solving it. You've got to check for those restrictions. If you use the least common denominator, you can eliminate the fractions. And sometimes when that happens, you will then get a quadratic, which would need to maybe factor and solve, or quadratic formula. You could even complete the square. And then be sure and take both of those answers and plug them back in to check to make sure that they both work. Definitely thanks for watching. If the videos are helping, please subscribe to the channel and don't forget to share with your friends. Thanks.